I want to thank WD-40 for sponsoring this video. Hey everybody, it's Ryan. Welcome back to How Farms Work. As many of you will remember, we knocked the barn down last month due to the damage that it received during the derecho on August 10th. Well, we have yet to clean up the barn roof, so we're gonna fire up the JCB and head down into the barnyard and start cleaning that up. So there's a lot of work that needs to be done down the barnyard before winter, and getting the roof cleaned up is the first step. So let's head out to the machine shed and fire up the JCB. Before we get started, I want to talk a little bit about one of our sponsors, WD-40. As many of you know, we've been working with WD-40 to promote their Specialist line of products the last couple years. And I have a can of WD-40 Specialist white lithium grease here that we're going to be using on the overhead door track. And you guys may notice that it looks a lot like the WD-40 multi-use product cans. So their Specialist line has gone through a rebranding. They found that people identify this look more with WD-40. So when they're going through and looking on store shelves, this kind of catches their eye a little bit easier. They went from the black can and yellow cap to the traditional blue and gray can to the red top. And that's the new look of the Specialist line. So if you guys go to the store and you're looking for any of the Specialist products, this is what they look like right here. The WD-40 multi-use product is probably the most recognizable can that you'll find in any shops or farm, because it's pretty much a staple of any person who works in their own machinery. Now, a little fact about the original WD-40 multi-use product is that it was actually developed for use in space as a water displacer, and it literally helped launch rockets into space. And the fact that it found its way onto farms across the world is pretty neat. That same scientific expertise led to the development of over 20 new Specialist products that we've been promoting on our channel the last few years. And that includes degreasers, greases, lubricants, penetrants, and other products that you guys can find on WD-40's website. So I'll put the link down in the description if you guys are interested in more of their Specialist products. We've been using them around the farm. Pretty much anytime I break out one of these cans, they don't last long because they're usually the first thing that we reach for whenever we're doing work in the machine shed. Now we're gonna spray this into the overhead door track and see if we can make it a little bit easier to open and close these doors. Now, as we move towards winter, there's ice that builds up on the machine shed itself, as well as on the ground. So when I'm standing here with two hands on the door trying to pull it open, and I can't get a good footing, even right now, it's kind of difficult to open this thing. Your feet have a tendency to slip, and if you're got one foot on each side of the door, I don't have to tell you guys what happens when you lose your footing. Let's get up there and spray this in there. I bet these door rails haven't seen any TLC probably since the shed was built. And Dad estimates that the shed was probably built in probably around 1968. He said that the shed was here before Grandpa bought the place in the 70s. Pretty much filling the whole track up with this. Now on the can, it says that it's ideal for use on auto hinges, gears, sprockets, outdoor hinges, latches, overhead door tracks, pulleys, cables, and guide rails. And this is stuff that you want to be using if you're putting something away for a while and you don't want it to seize up on you. This is the stuff to use. I'm going to close the door now and get it over here where I've already sprayed. I can't forget to do this part of the rail as well. And I'm going to try to spray the wheels on the door. Oh yeah. Those rollers really needed this. Here's the other roller. Just give that a good spray around. I just put this whole can into the track on the machine shed. Granted, it spans the whole length of the shed, so I feel like a can went pretty far. Let's try the doors and see if it made a difference. Yeah, yeah, I would say that opens and closes a lot easier. Yeah, I'd say that made quite a bit of a difference. Don't be like us. Your tracks need some TLC too every now and then. Let's go clean up the barn. I just folded over the roof on itself. And I'm carrying it down in mostly one big chunk. Got the barn all cleaned up, so now we need to fill up and level out where the fence line was. So Dad called in 3 loads of gravel that we're going to use as filler to hopefully smooth it off a little bit, make it a little bit easier to get in and out of, so it's less of a steep grade when you're going through the gateway. So here you can see that we have kind of a sharp drop off where the fence was. The fence was holding the dirt back on the other side of the fence, and this has just been kind of eroding away. Oh boy. Never seen a dump truck drift before. That was kind of neat. So I'm gonna go grab the JCB and I'm going to start working that gravel down along that edge there. I'm gonna try to be filling and basically filling up this whole area in here. I'd like to work it up to the water cement over there because the cows have a pretty steep step to get up onto that cement pad. And with all the rain that we had gotten, it's obviously not dried. I thought or hoped that it would dry a little bit, but it doesn't really seem like it has much at all. So let's go grab the JCB and start working that gravel back and forth. I told him that I'd try to bring it up a little bit so that he could get it down there as far as possible, because if he puts it up by the machine shed, that's going to be a lot of driving back and forth with the JCB. No, thank you. A lot of gravel. Two down, one more to go. Looks like me putting the gravel down really helped. Now, since we took the barn out, we don't have any power going down to that water down there. So what we had to do is we called an electrician. They ran a power line underground. They trenched one down the road here, and that's probably why you got stuck the first time, is because it's supposed to be gravel, but that trencher, besides from the water issues that we've had in the past, last fall we had to dig up a couple spots, so it's particularly muddy in here, so it's probably a good thing that I put the gravel down. But
Yeah, he got stuck that last time, but it looks like it worked out pretty good. So
he's gonna get one more load dropped off, and then I'm gonna be able to spread this out with the JCB, like I said, try to fill up this a little bit, and that way there's not such a steep drop off. Now what I gotta do once I get this all leveled out is I have a measuring wheel. I need to measure what I need for gates, because there was a wood fence in here before. What I'm thinking about doing now is putting up wood or metal gates, and that way I can go from here to wherever I need to, get probably a couple 16 footers, make the gate as wide as I need to, hopefully before the ground freezes, come out here and pound some posts in. And what I'd like to do while we have the post pounder out here is to come over on this other side of the barn and put a couple of posts in where that jimmy rigged fence is there, because that fence is there so that when we bring the calves out of the pole shed, they don't run down in there. Because once we get it down, them down into that lot, what they tend to do is literally run from one corner back to the other, and we can't get them out of there, and they get kind of all flustered up. That way, if we put posts in there, I can buy a couple gates to put through there that's kind of more sturdy than what we've got now, and that way they don't really have much of a choice. Then we can set them up to run them right in here to the barn, and that'll get us by until we can get a newer building in here, which might be a few years. We're having them just dump off three loads. If I need them to bring more, I'm gonna give them a call and have them deliver more. I might do some more work to the driveway, especially going down to the chicken house, so that way it's not just a mud pit down there from trenching the power line for the water. Bard always has the nicest trucks. They do a heck of a lot better job at keeping their trucks clean than I do. There, we've got our gravel pile.
Let's fire up the JCB and spread it out.
I love this thing so much. I just point and she goes. What a beaut.
Doesn't look too bad if I say so myself. What we're using here is 3/4 road gravel, and ideally this is what we wanted to put down because it has a good tendency to compact. It's what is underneath and it's held up pretty well over the years, but it definitely needed a little boost on this side. Now the part of the plan is to come in here and haul this manure pack out, and I'd love to be able to build this back up in here rather than it being a mud hole, as you guys can see over there.
So this is what three loads did. It got that edge smoothed off there. Looks pretty good. I'd like to get
Actually, I already called in for two more loads, so they're going to bring that tonight or tomorrow. And that way I can just kind of fill it out just a little bit more, push out. I'd like to get down closer to that gateway and get on the lower side of that cement pad down there. And that way I can just kind of build it up in here a little bit more and try to ease it off a little bit. I'd like to put a little bit more of a ledge up this side so that it's not angled down towards the barnyard quite so much. I'd like to build that back up just a little bit. I'm sure some of you pros are watching me do that and are like, what the heck? I'm not a pro, but I mean, I do enjoy doing grading with the JCB. That thing is just flat out awesome, especially for tasks like this. So I didn't get it the smoothest in the world, but it is what it is. Like I said, I'd love to come in here and haul out that manure pack before it all freezes and take it out to the field. The cows are standing on the other side of the gate there, currently working on the fence around the field because I want to let them out there, hopefully get them a little bit more feed so I don't have to start feeding quite as heavily. I've already started putting bales out for them, and the gate to the 11 acres has been open for almost a week now and they still haven't found it, so Mom's trying to coax them out there right now. But they won't leave. They're sitting here waiting for a bale. So now that I have that smoothed off enough, I can go ahead and measure it. So like I said earlier, I'm planning on putting gates in here. I need to know how many posts I want to put in. So I have this handy dandy measuring wheel. It's not the most accurate thing in the world, but it'll give me a rough estimate on how many gates I need and how many posts or where I'm going to need to put the posts. So I'm going to go ahead and reset the counter here. And I'm going to start walking from this edge of the barn over to the water. So from the corner of the barn over to here, it's 66 feet. So now I'm going to have to go back to the playbook and do some math. So from here to there, it would take 4.25 16-foot gates. Which 16-foot gates are actually 15 and a half feet. It's just how I came up with that measurement. But we need to come up, find a spot where we want the gate to be. It was roughly here to here. So I need to start figuring out where to put the posts and what size gates to order. Now that's pretty well going to sum up this video. That backfill on the lower side of the water concrete pad down there isn't going to take much. Anything left, I'll probably keep trying to smooth this off. Depending on how it all turns out, what I end up doing. I was talking about putting gates in here. We'll just have to wait and see what we do. I mean, it would be nice to put a wood fence in here because the whole other sides of the lot are wood fence. And that way I could get gate, I think, a little bit. I could get it where I want it a little bit easier. So, I don't know. I'd like to have it, like, right here. And then be a 16-footer over in that direction. So, I don't know. I'll keep you guys updated on how the lot turns out. For right now, gonna figure out what we're gonna do from here. How many posts I'm gonna need. What we're gonna do. Need some time to be thought about some more yet. So anyway, that's pretty much it for this video. Thanks for watching, guys. Be sure to check out all of our other videos. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. And be sure to follow us on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Snapchat. All How Farms Work. And with that, I'll see you next time.